Rod Serling. You're listening to The Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, Keith Walker's caustic account of disorganized crime. A favor he can't refuse. Starring William Shatner. In a Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the Ford Motor Company, Shenley Industries, Matus Wine, Beechnut Chewing Tobacco, and Dial Soap. This is The Zero Hour on Mutual Radio.
Peter Principle calls for a person to rise to their own level of incompetence. That's the problem of a region syndicate chieftain when he tries to do away with our easygoing hero, Elliot Angelino, in this piece titled, A Favor You Can't Refuse.
Hey, come on, you bum. I'll race you to the float.
Don't leave me alone.
Hey, come on. Look at you. Look like an almond joy.
Oh, come on.
Coochie.
Oh, no fair.
Hey, come on. Try some of this warm
ice. Come here, you. Come here.
No, you don't.
Come on. Hey, oh.
It's not nice to fool with Mother Karate. Come on. You're going to soak.
You let go of my foot.
Big man, huh?
Will you quit that? How's it going to look? A petite blonde dragging her man through the sand? You, him, I, Jane. Let's go.
Hey, last one to the floor. Eat the peanut butter sandwich.
Lunch too, hey, guy. You think of everything. Hey, no. The backstroke? The gall of that woman.
Come on, hero. Good grief. My dog could do a better paddle.
I must be out of condition.
Here, take my hand.
How could you? Where's my pride?
Right. Now take my hand.
Well, thank you, sweet maiden. You saved my life.
But nothing fair, Knight.
Take it down.
They were
over the side, quick. I'm beginning to feel like a duck in a gallery.
This is no time for jokes.
I'm not joking. Move around to this side. Where's the thermos?
How can you think of drinking at a time?
Where's the thermos?
This side of the float, I think. Al, where are you going?
Dee, swim for the shore.
Al, you okay?
I'm coming.
What happened?
Let's get to shore. I waited till they got close, then threw the thermos, got the driver. Boat crashed in the dock.
What happened?
Look, hey, will somebody call the police? Yeah. There's been an accident.
Oh, an accident. Hell, good grief. Look at our room. It's been torn apart.
It figures.
You mean the money?
Yeah, this is getting complicated.
Where did you hide it?
Behind the air conditioning grill.
Hell, it's not here.
Naturally. First thing they did was say, look behind the air conditioner grill.
Elliot!
Okay.
How much was there? You never told me.
$1 million.
$1 million?
You better get that oiled.
Well, what are we going to do now?
Go back to the States.
$1 million?
You've been going on and on about that.
You really think we've been set up?
But you and the lady care for wine with dinner?
Yes.
Well, I will bring it.
Yes.
Yes, what?
Yes, I think we were set up, but I can't believe the syndicate would do it.
Oh, they wouldn't try to kill you.
I don't know. Dad's been dead a year. Maybe they decided the son should be put out of the way.
Oh, I don't believe it. Your dad was always so respected by all the families. Everyone looked up to him.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you've never talked very much about him.
I respected him, even if I didn't agree with what he was.
Ah. Is that why you didn't take over when he died?
Shrimp and a steak, no?
I'm shrimp, she's steak.
I have sharper teeth. He has to gum it.
Enjoy it, crazy gringos.
Well?
Well, Dad was getting old. I think he felt his only son should go legit. I agreed.
You loved him very much, didn't you?
Can I have your carrots? Yeah, I did.
If you felt so strongly, why did you agree to Mr. Bottolucci's request?
To take the money? I don't know. He was always a friend of Dad's. He asked a favor. Said the money was payment to one of their South American operations.
Funny that the contact never showed.
Yeah. You want your salad?
Maybe we should have kept the money.
Maybe that's what Giovanni wanted.
Come in.
You sent for me, Giovanni?
Mr. Bottolucci. Sit down. Batista, I have a contract to let. Are you interested?
I do not like to be called a hoodlum.
$50,000?
Who?
Elliot Angelino.
When?
Go to Los Angeles. He'll be coming in by plane shortly. Follow him. Await my instructions. Hey, good evening, Spencer. How's the wheel?
Good, sir. Very good.
Hello, Ginny. Doing good tonight?
Sure. The sucker's always biting.
Very good. Parker, Bert, have the pit boss. Change of cards.
Hello.
Hey, what's wrong up there?
Oh, nothing, Mr. Bottolucci.
Spencer's been dumping to a friend for 20 minutes.
Si, mi piace, but I'll take care right away.
You take care of it. Permanent.
Permanent? Well, okay, if you...
Giovanni, New York? All right, 5 minutes. Vegas, Bottolucci. I'll hold.
Giovanni, are you well?
Oh, yes, sir, Mr. Costa. Thank you.
Giovanni, I have heard things I'm not happy with.
I'm sorry, sir. Can I help?
Is it true that you have let a contract on the son of my old friend?
Yes, I'm sorry to tell you.
Why?
I did not mean to hide anything from you, but as head of the Western region, I felt it was my duty to protect our mutual interests.
How is that?
Well, it's in the report to your office last week, sir. The boy has been found to be skimming.
How much?
Almost $1 million over the last 3 weeks.
I don't believe this. You would not do such a thing.
It is my honor, eh?
I see. All right. You are responsible for the discipline in your region. But the money must be recovered, if at all possible.
Oh, thank you. I can assure you, we will try.
Deirdre Knowles?
Yes?
Get in the car.
I will not.
Unless you wish to die on this street, you will do as I ask. Golly.
Why are you doing this? Has it something to do with Elliot?
Yes, you are the bait.
Yeah, that may be, but it's not pertinent. You'll be safe if you follow instructions.
Al, don't listen to them.
Dee, whoever you are, don't harm her.
Hey, as long as you do as I say, we won't touch her. Now, we want a meeting. 3 a.m. at the marina. A boat named Marianne and Slip 5.
But what are you...
Good. Hey, Lee, take her down the car. Mr. Bartolucci? freeze and hey. Do not move.
Tuffy, it's me, Bonalucci.
Oh, please step aboard, sir.
Where's the girl?
Below.
How long for Angelino?
I would say about now, wouldn't you?
Hey! Ow!
Ah, that's enough, Lee. That's enough. Take him below. You are too predictable, Elliot. Not your father's son.
What do you mean?
Well, we expected you to come early. Tuppy, time up. Lee, shove off. We have only 40 minutes to rendezvous. Patience, my dear Miss Knowles. Oh, I must say, the gag is very becoming.
Hey, not so tight.
Relax. Enjoy the few moments that remain in your life. Tuppy, you may ungag the lady.
Hurt me! You creep! Let me up or I'll kill you!
On the contrary, it is I that will kill you. Very shortly.
You'll be caught.
I hardly think so. I planned this very carefully. Very carefully. You see, ever since your father died, some members of the council have maintained that it is you that should be heading the Western region. Of course, I could not have that. So I arranged for you to act as courier, thus placing the loss of that million on you. Then I set up the books so that they show an additional $7 million that's been taken out over the past year.
But the controls?
A simple matter. They are flawed. I merely affixed to your code to the receipts. So now, getting rid of you has the approval of the council. Alas, they will be advised that we're unable to find the missing money. Sad, isn't it? The son of Angelino has betrayed the family.
You hated my father, didn't you?
Always. Always. It was always him the council listened to, never me. Well, this will show them how much they can respect me. I've shown the son of Angelino to be a thief. I'm afraid this conversation must wait. Tuppy, help Lee tie to the freighter. Oh, you two may have a few moments.
I'm sorry, my darling.
It's okay. I should have pulled away completely years ago. It's my own fault for accepting the casino job. Giovanni's a fool, though. I would never have gotten involved in the family again.
You are the cum.
Will you untie us?
Soon. Up the ladder, please.
Al, it's some kind of a freight ship.
Signora Bottolucci.
Captain Rossi. I brought some friends.
Please, come aboard.
Come on, you two. Hurry. Captain, is everything in order?
Si, very much so. Enter your cargo.
Ah. In the walls of the boat. Can your crane accommodate it?
Oh, sure. I will attend to it. Why don't you and your friends go along to my sea cabin?
Well, thank you.
That's very clever, Giovanni. Is all the money stashed in the boat?
Yes. And thank you. I appreciate the compliment.
What do you intend to do with us?
Oh, you disappoint me, Miss Knowles. I thought it would be obvious once we set to sea. Well...
Oh, Al!
This captain, is he in this with you?
He's an old friend in need of money. We'll receive a small percentage once the $7 million is safe in a Swiss bank. Oh, I believe this is the captain's cabin.
Good evening, Giovanni.
Mr. Costa.
All of you, please come in. DeVitos, please close the door.
Yes, Mr. Costa.
I don't know why I came to Vegas with you. I mean, that was a dirty trick to pull.
I couldn't help it. The Mr. Costa came to me with his suspicions and asked for the family's sake if I would help. It was a favor... I could not refuse, as oh. the saying.
And Teffy, is that really his name?
No. The beast that means hoodlum. But he's called that with affection. Teffy was in Mr. Costa's confidence from the start, but his word was not enough for Costa to justify removal. of Giovanni. After all, he was a regional chief. This is not the old days, my love.
You mind if I join you two?
Not at all, please.
We just finished the meeting of the council. They were disappointed, Elliot.
Disappointed with what, El?
I was asked to take over the region.
No.
No, it's okay. I refused.
Well, I won't take up that cliche, but it would have been like the old days. Angeline, who at the table.
I think my father would have approved my decision.
I'm sure he would. He and I talked at length about you before he died.
I didn't know.
Only a few minutes before my plane, so... this is for you and the lady.
A check?
Yes, yes. You call it a finder's fee, eh? I must go now. Please, remember, mio fratello, we are always at your service.
Grazie. Well enough.
El, what did he call you?
Brother.
Is, the check... Well, could I see it?
Sure.
Oh!
Now, that's the first time I've ever seen you speechless.
I never saw it. Stefano,
put it in your sock. We'll use it on our honeymoon.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes. Exercise your imagination. And join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
A Favor You Can't Refuse is an original radio drama written by Keith Walker. William Shatner is heard as Elliot Angelini. Featured in the cast were Peggy Walton, John Large, Casey Kasem, Jack Crucian, and Ben Wright. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Coulis, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music is composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman, Rochelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.